So this is a weekly chart. When you look at the Kumo here, what would you see? All right, just focus on the Kumo direction. And when you look at the Kumo direction, do you think it's moving up, down, or horizontal? Which direction is it? Okay, it's down, down, horizontal. Okay, I've got one horizontal and, all right, two horizontal and down, down, downtrend, downtrend. All right, all right. Yeah, this might be a little bit of a tricky question. In this case, the Kumo is becoming horizontal now. In this case, the Kumo is becoming horizontal. Last time it was moving down, but right now it's becoming horizontal. So you can just recognize this as a horizontal. Yeah, however, this is stable bearish momentum, right? This is still bearish momentum. The market is consolidating right now because the Kumo is horizontal, but this is stable bearish. And within this bearish momentum, the Kumo is becoming horizontal. The market is consolidating right now. And here is why. First evidence is that the Senko Span 2 is becoming flat here, right? Well, actually, Senko Span 2 or Senko Span B, the upper side, right? Upper part of this Kumo here is called Senko Span B. And when it's flat, that means the market is consolidating, right? Basically, that when the Senko Span B is flat, that means the market is consolidating right now. And that means the market is not really renewing the highs or lows in this case. That's why Senko Span 2 is flat here. So this is one of the confirmations for the range. And also, when you look at the candlesticks, so this is actually the new topic here. This is the new topic. So you know the direction of the Kumo, you know the Senko Span 2. When it's flat, it's consolidation. And I will add one more information here today, right? So when it's on a bearish trend, in this case, this is a bearish trend, and when Kumo is sloping down, and when the candlesticks are also sloping down, you have to watch out for these lows. You take these important lows, you take these lows and you measure the distance between this low to the Kumo, like this. So when you were looking at this candlestick right here, when the Kumo was forming was 26 candles ahead, right? When you were looking at this low right here, the Kumo was forming 26 candles ahead. So that means the Kumo was forming 26 candles forwarded, right? So it was here. When you were looking at this low, the Kumo was like this. You measure the distance between this low to the Kumo and the gap, right? You see the gap here. And this is pretty wide. And that means the market is still bearish momentum. It's continuously bearish. So, and this can be the confirmation, right? So the distance between the candle and also the Kumo can tell you also the momentum of the market. And when it's far, when there's a gap, like a wide gap, then that means the bearish momentum is still continuous, right? And similarly, right? In contrast, when the Kumo is moving up, you watch out for these highs and you look at the distance, right? Between this high to the Kumo, when it was forming, and when the market loses its momentum, the highs or lows will be getting closer to the Kumo. If I do it, you know, step by step here, if you take this low here, and if you again measure 26 bars in the future, it's gonna be on this candlestick right here, right? This blue one. So I put the vertical line here. So this was a Kumo that we were looking at when the market marked the low here, right? And when you just draw the line from this low to the Kumo here. Let me do precise it here. So when you draw a line like this, this is still far, right? This is still far. So in this case, when you were actually watching this low here, you can still be positive when you are selling it, right? You can still go to bed when you are having sell position here, or you can start thinking about selling it here. How about this one? This is a recent low on this place, and how about 26 candles ahead is going to be on this Kumo right here, right? So it was somewhere here. So when you were watching this low, the Kumo was forming here. And if you look at the distance like this, it's still far. So you can still be positive for this bearish momentum in this case. My expectation is that the market will keep going down in this case. So this is something that you can tell from the Kumo and also the distance between the lows or highs. Everybody understanding so far? And of course you can draw lines like this, right? You can of course draw lines and see if it's getting lower lows. here and if it's getting lower highs here, right? So this channel actually telling you the market to be bearish too, but also you can take these lows and compare these locations to the Kumo and see if the market is still continuously bearish or not. And right now looks like it's been touching on this trend line. I'm expecting the price to be keep going down. That way you can create the scenario of for the sell in this case. Alright, so but let's say the market it's horizontal because the market is consolidating right now, right? So let's say the market starts to go down but pushes back up somewhere, right? And in that case, this one is going to be the recent low. Or you can even look at this one, right? These ones will be the low, right? And when it happens on the market, that means the distance between the low to the Kumo is getting smaller, right? Compared to here. It's becoming very small. As the gap becoming smaller, that means there's more chance that the market will be turning to bullish momentum in this case. And when that happens, Senko Span B remains flat. Maybe it's gonna be sloping down a little bit, but still remains flat. The distance between these lows and Kumo is getting smaller and smaller, and eventually the price will be breaking inside of the Kumo. And there might be a chance that it's going to be breaking this high, Senko Span B, upwards. So you have to watch out for that. When these lows are getting closer to the Kumo. So this is something that you have to remember. When the Kumo is moving down, you focus on these lows. You know, you take these lows and you measure the distance between these lows and the Kumo. And when it's moving up, you know, in contrast, when the Kumo is moving up, you take the highs and you compare the distance between the Kumo and these highs.